Hello, and welcome to this Delphi Display Systems training video entitled Content Management for Your Delphi Order Confirmation System. My name is Ken Mather, and I'll be your instructor. By watching this instructional video, you'll learn how to use Delphi's Display Manager software to alter the content of your display. To begin, you'll need a laptop or desktop computer with a Display Manager, also known as DM, software loaded. This software is provided with all new Delphi displays on two CDs. If you cannot locate the CDs, you can also download the software directly from Delphi's website. The DM software is certified on all PC operating systems including Windows 7. However, DM is not compatible with Mac. You can connect to the display in one of three ways: dial-up, serial, or network. Dial-up is the slowest method, as all data transfers take place through the phone line. The benefit to using dial-up is it allows a user to send an update to the display without actually having to be at the store. To dial in remotely, you must have a computer with a modem, and you must have someone at the store connect the phone cord to the line connection on the bottom of the Delphi IMS. Serial is the most common way to update displays, and it's much faster than dial-up. However, the user must be at the store where the display is located to use this type of connectivity. You'll need to connect your laptop or desktop computer to the PC port on the Delphi IMS using a patch cord and USB to serial adapter. Your computer's connection will be USB, and the PC connection on the IMS is serial. If you don't have a USB to serial adapter, you can order one from the Delphi website. The fastest way to update your display is by using network connectivity. This method is only an option if your display has a network connector on the back and there is a cable running from this connector to the network switch inside the store. If it does, you can run a Cat5 patch cable from your computer to an open port on the same network switch that the display is plugged into. The first time you use your DM software after installing it, you must be connected to a display using one of the three methods we just mentioned. After initial use, you can build and modify configurations on the DM software anytime and anywhere. It's only when you're ready to send the configuration to a display you must be connected. Once you have the software open, the first thing you need to do is add your store's display to the list of displays in your software. To do this, on the toolbar, go to OCS Displays and choose Add OCS Display. A window will appear indicating that the system is searching for OCS displays. It scans both your local network as well as your serial ports. After a quick search, it will list any and all displays it finds. At this point, it knows a few things about the displays it's found, including which series display it is, the application version, the method of connection, including the display's IP address, the date and time on the display, and the POS interface loaded onto the display. Highlight the display you want to connect to and type a name for that display. Your best bet is to identify your displays by your store number, and if your store has more than one display, follow the store number with an A or a B. For purposes of this training, I'm going to call this display Test Display. Click the Add Display button, and the display will now be listed in the DM software. Although you have just added this display to your software, you're not connected to it just yet. To connect to the display, place your cursor over the display name in the left column, then right-click, and choose Connect to OCS Display. Since this is the first time you'll be connecting to the display, it will open a window asking if you want to verify the identity of the display. Choose Yes. This is a security measurement to keep you from listing the same display multiple times. Each display is unique, and if it detects you already have this display in your system under a different name, it will warn you. Next, it will ask you to verify which connection method you'll be using to connect to the display. If you have a physical connection to the display, both through serial as well as through the network, both will be available, essentially allowing you to choose which method you want to use. Since our display is currently physically connected through the network, this is our only choice. Select OK. The system will then begin handshaking with the display, and when connection is successful, you'll be prompted. Select OK. The next thing you want to do, only when using your software for the first time, is a process called Retrieve Configuration. This process actually pulls a configuration from the display and adds it to your DM software. If you loaded the DM software from a set of CDs and you utilize CD number 2 during installation, you will not need to perform this step. Right-click on the name of your display, then choose Retrieve Configuration. You'll be asked if you want to retrieve or pull back all of the image files from the display. If you check the box, the file transfer will take a little longer because more data is being pulled. However, again, if you are using DM for the first time and did not use CD number 2 during installation, this is recommended. Click the Start button. At this point, all the configuration files will begin to transfer from the display to your DM software. You can see the progress in the bottom window as each file is transferred. To complete the transfer, you'll be prompted to enter a name of this configuration. The name you choose should be specific to either the store, the region, the market, or something that is at least descriptive. For example, if you have stores across several different regions, and you want some displays to have some pictures, while other displays have other pictures, then you'll want to name the configurations according to their region. For our purposes, we'll name it Test Display Configuration, then hit Save. Now that the configuration is saved in my DM software, I'll choose a configuration so I can see it and begin making changes. Select Configurations in the bottom left window, which will list all the saved configurations in the top left window. In this example, we have two different saved configurations. Sample Configuration, which automatically loaded during installation, and Test Display Configuration, the one we just pulled back from the display. By selecting one of them on the left, the right side will then show the daypart detail for that configuration. In this case, we have a default, lunch, and dinner daypart. All of the images within each daypart are also represented. While looking at any configuration, you'll see an available graphics window along the bottom. It's recommended to make the DM software full screen at this point to allow visibility of more images. Before you can add any images to your configuration, they must first be imported into the available graphics window. You can import either a single image file or an entire folder full of images. First, let's try importing a single image file. Right-click anywhere in the available graphics window and choose Import Graphic File. A browser window will open, allowing you to select the location and the file you want to import. When you've found it, click Open, and the file appears in the available graphics window and is ready to add to a daypart. Next, let's try importing an entire folder full of images. Right-click anywhere in the available graphics window and choose Import Graphics Folder. Again, a browser window will open, and you can browse to find the folder you want to import. Once you've found it, select OK, and all of the images within that folder will now appear in the available graphics window. To add a graphic to any of the existing dayparts, simply left-click on any of the graphics in the available graphics window, then drag it to the appropriate daypart, and drop it by releasing the left button. You can place it anywhere in the daypart, even between two other images. If you're not happy with where you dropped it, simply grab it again and drop it in a different place. This drag-and-drop method makes building your dayparts a snap. By double-clicking on the image in the daypart, you'll bring up the image properties. It lists the name of the image, the resolution, and the slideshow duration, which means how long that particular image will show on the screen before advancing to the next image. By default, this is set at 3 seconds, which is recommended for most images. If your image has additional text on it, you may want to increase this duration time to 4 or 5 seconds, giving the customers time to read it. If you want to add the same image to another day part, or even all your day parts, you can simply drag it from one day part to another, where it will place a copy. If you want to change the slideshow duration on each individual copy, you may do so. To remove a graphic from a day part, just grab it, drag it to the available graphics window, and drop it. You'll be asked if you're sure you want to delete the graphic. Just click Yes. You can do this as many times as it takes to remove all the necessary graphics. To change a sidebar graphic, delete it by dragging it to the available graphics window, then grab the appropriate new sidebar from that window, and drag it back up to the sidebar graphic column. To add a new daypart, right-click anywhere in the OCS Configurations window and select New Daypart. A window will open that will allow you to set the parameters of the new daypart. First, name your daypart. In this case, we'll call it Breakfast. If you want your new daypart to be active all the time, check the Always Active button. If not, enter the time of day you want the daypart to start, followed by the time you want it to end. Next, if you want the daypart to apply to every day of the week, check the All button. If not, uncheck All, and check only the days of the week you want this daypart to be active. In this case, we're going to keep it active every day of the week, so recheck All, and then select OK. Now the new daypart is added, and you can see the start time, end time, and days of the week it will be active. Next, we can start adding the graphics we want, beginning with a sidebar graphic. One by one, start adding graphics by using the drag and drop method. If you mistakenly add a wrong graphic, simply remove it like we did previously. If you want to delete a day part, just highlight which one you would like to remove, then right-click and select Delete Day Part. You will be asked if you're sure you want to delete it. Just select Yes. Throughout the year, you may experience different promotions within your brand that have specific start and stop dates. These promotions often include POP material that you display around the store, as well as digital graphics for use in your COD. Display Manager allows the user to create a new day part and assign it a specific start date and end date. By using this feature, you can be sure that on the first day of the promotion, your new graphic will show automatically, and that it will stop showing automatically when the promotion is ended. To add a promo day part, add a new day part just as we did previously. Create a name for the new day part that is descriptive, in this case, May Promo Lunch. Set the start time and the end time of the day part, and choose which days of the week you want it to show. Next, select the date you want the day part to begin, followed by the date you want it to end. Click OK when you're done. Now you can begin adding graphics to the day part, starting with the sidebar. Unlike the other day parts, You can see now that this day part has a start date and an end date. When this start date and time is reached, the display will begin running this day part in place of any other normal day part. When it has detected that the date range is complete at the end of the promotion, this day part will again lay dormant, and the display will go back to utilizing the normal day parts assigned to that time slot. After creating a new day part, or altering an existing day part, it's always recommended to preview it before uploading it to a display. To do this, highlight any day part, right-click, and choose Preview Day Part. A window will open, and the day part graphics will begin to play in exactly the same manner as they would on a display. This allows you to make sure that everything looks good and you're happy with the results before you upload it to a display. This is especially handy when you've added a graphic with text on it and want to make sure it shows on the screen long enough for your customers to read before moving to the next graphic. Click Exit Preview when you're done. Although the display requires power 24 hours a day, the display has the ability to go to sleep as determined by the customer. Programming how and when the display goes to sleep is called store hours. In some cases, customers may want the display to wake up and start showing graphics at opening time, then go to sleep when they close. Others may want the display to go to sleep automatically 40 minutes after an order. Others yet may want their display to stay awake at all times. To make any changes to these hours, click on Store Hours under Your Configuration on the left side of the screen. This will open the Store Hours window. Now click on the Edit button at the bottom. If you want the display to go to sleep automatically after a specific set of minutes following an order, click the Enable button under Shutdown Timer. Type in the number of minutes you want the system to wait following an order before it goes to sleep. If you prefer the display to awaken at a specific hour, first make sure Disable is selected at the top, then set the open and close hours for each day of the week according to your store's hours. If your store is open 24 hours and you would prefer the display never went to sleep, make sure Disable is selected near the top, then check the box for Always Open. When you're done making your changes, click OK. If you're not happy with the way your screen looks during the order process, you can change it. To do this, click the plus sign next to the word Screens in the left column, then choose Order Screen. What you see on the screen is exactly how your screen will appear during an order, with the exception of the food descriptions themselves. The layout is comprised of multiple sections. Depending on which layout you're currently using, you may or may not have these same choices on your screen currently. In any of these sections, you can change just about everything, from the background color to the color of the text, and then some. For example, if you want to make changes to the section of the screen detailing the ordered items, just click anywhere in that section, and the Order Window properties will appear. First, you can change the font style. Below that, Use Custom Price Format is only for stores outside of the U.S. who use a currency symbol other than the dollar sign. Next is Order Item Options, where you can change the font colors of the quantity, the item price, and the descriptions. Next is the Modifier Item Options, where you can again change the fonts, but specifically for all modifiers. Next is the Background section, where you can choose between either a solid colored background or use a graphic as a background like this example. If you want to change the background graphic, click on the box to open the browser, which then allows you to choose from any of the graphics in the available graphics window. You can select a graphic, choose Open, then click Apply, and you will immediately see the change on your layout screen. If you would rather have a solid color as the background, you can select Color, choose the appropriate color, then click Apply. In this example, we're going to change just the background and the color of the descriptions. Next, we'll change the total window properties by clicking in that section. Here again, you can change everything from the background to the font colors. You can even choose whether or not you want the tax to show. However, this is usually reserved for international customers, where in some countries, tax is built right into the item prices. For our example, we'll change only the background color. Next, we have the message window. By selecting this window, you can make all types of changes from background and font color to changing the wordings of the message and how it will appear to the customer, known as the effect. Using the effect type, you can make the message flash, scroll different directions, or just stay static. You can change the background color. To turn off the text, just uncheck the text message box. You can change the font color just like in the other sections. You can change the wording of the message by typing in the text message box, then click Apply. You can also choose to include a logo or graphic before and after the message. To do this, click the Enable Logo box, then browse to the graphic you want to include. For our example, we're going to change the font color, the effect, and add a graphic. At this point, you can easily see all the changes that will take place on your display after you perform the update. Although it may appear you can change the sidebar graphic in this section, clicking on it will let you know that you must do this in the day part section, as we did previously. The end of order screen is a screen the customer will see after their order is complete, showing them their total. To modify this screen, click on End of Order Screen in the column to the left, and a representation of your current end of order screen will show. Click anywhere on this window, and the Properties window will open. From here, you can make several changes including font color, background, text message editing, and even how long the screen will show on the display. In this example, we just changed the font color to green. Next, we'll change the wording of the message itself. One very important note to remember when editing the text is making sure the pipe symbol is always present. On the end of order screen, the pipe symbol is a placeholder so the display knows where to place the actual dollar amount. If you do not have a pipe symbol as part of the message, the amount will not show. The pipe symbol is typically found on a key near the Enter key on the keyboard and looks like two vertical dashes. In our example, we're going to move the thank you to the beginning and add some exclamation marks. We can't forget to remove the thank you from the bottom, which is down a couple of lines. Click OK and the change is reflected. If you're not happy with the positioning, go back into the text editing and move the text down one line. When an order is canceled on the POS, the display will show an order canceled screen. Like all the other screens, this too is configurable. To change this screen, click on the Cancel screen on the left side. And you'll see the current screen as it appears to the customer. To make a change, click on the screen to bring up the Properties window and begin making your changes. For our example, we'll change to the wording. Now that we've made all the changes we want to the configuration, we're going to preview them. To do this, we go back into Dayparts by clicking on the daypart name on the left side of the screen. Select any of the dayparts, right-click, and choose Preview Daypart. Just like the earlier preview we did, you'll see the graphic slideshow as it will appear to the customer. This time, however, we're going to use a toolbar to simulate an order, which will then show us exactly how the order will appear now that we've made changes. Click New Order, and the preview will begin to show an order using the order screen we created. Next, click Finish Order to simulate the end of the customer's order, and the total screen will appear, again showing our changes. The preview will then go back to showing graphics, just like the display will do. You can click the Cancel Order button to see what the screen will look like if an order is canceled. When you're done, click Exit Preview. At this point, all of our changes to the configuration are complete, and we're ready to send this configuration to the display. First, we want to save all the changes we just made by clicking the Save icon. Next, we want to right-click on the configuration name, then select Send Configuration to OCS. A window will appear that will ask you to confirm which display you want to send the new configuration to. If you have added new graphics to the dayparts, ensure the Graphic Files box is checked. If you don't check this box, none of the new images will be sent to the display. If you have only deleted graphics but have not added any new graphics, uncheck this box. There's an error check report which will notify you if the system detected any errors in the configuration you created. One such error may be that you added a graphic that is not the correct size for the screen. This report gives you the opportunity to go back and correct errors. In our example, it has detected no errors and we're ready to send the configuration, so click Send. As the system is building the zip package to send to the OCS, it compares the names of the graphics you're sending to the names of the graphics already on the display. If it detects a match, it will ask you if you want to send those graphics anyway. It's recommended you don't, as it just makes the file unnecessarily larger, and it will take more time to perform the update. If, however, you know a graphic is different, however it shares the same name, check the box under the Send column and the new graphic will overwrite the old one. If you want to send them all anyway, check the Select All button. Click Continue. The package is built and the transfer begins. After a package is sent, you'll be asked if you want to clean the display. This means that all unused graphics in the display's memory will be deleted. It's highly recommended that you do this every time, as it ensures your display's memory will never reach capacity with old, outdated graphics, which could cause issues down the road. The display will now process the package and begin a reboot. Once that's complete, it will perform a clean process and report back if all was successful. The reboot process takes a couple minutes, so we'll speed up the video during this wait. Once you receive the confirmation the update was complete, you may either send the update to another display if one is connected, or simply disconnect as the process is complete. Thanks for watching this instructional video. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact our technical support department at any time.